Hello, I'm Christina from Milan Creative Co, and in this tutorial I'm going to show you how to vectorize watercolors using Illustrator. If you use watercolors to create patterns in Illustrator, you might have had trouble dragging the pattern swatch into the swatches panel or using the crop tool. That's because you used raster images, and some Illustrator tools only work with vectors. Before you start working on a pattern, you should always vectorize your graphics. I have here a watercolor stripe that was scanned at 300 dots per inch and then cleaned in Photoshop. Right now it has a transparent background. So just select it and then go to the arrow next to the image trace tool and open the menu. Choose high fidelity photo from the menu. You can use the same setting if you have any other type of drawing that has lots of details and colors. Now, once you click on it, you will get this notice that your tracing may proceed slowly, even if you have a good computer, because watercolors have so many details and sometimes files can be very large. So I'm going to click OK. My watercolor texture looks pretty good, but there are still some things we can change. So I'm going to open the image trace panel. You can also open it from window image trace, and then I'm going to open the advanced settings. When you vectorize watercolors, it's very important to look at the number of paths, anchors, and colors you have in your texture. The more paths and anchors you have, the larger your file will be. And watercolor files can be very big. I've recently worked with some floral watercolors and the files were as big as 200 megabytes, and such a large file is very hard to use, and even though I have a pretty good computer, it took a very long time to save the files or even move them around. One of the settings you can change is the color. I always make sure the palette is set to full tone, and then I increase the colors to 95% or sometimes even 100%. I'm not sure if there's any noticeable change, but you can see that the colors almost doubled, so you definitely have more details in your drawing. Another setting you can change is the number of paths. If you have a low number of paths, you might have many very small empty areas in your textures. It's easy to fix them, but it takes a lot of time, so I usually increase the paths a bit to something like 55% or maybe 60%. Let's see what happens. So when you are happy with how your texture looks, just close the image trace menu and click on expand. As you can see, we now have a vector. So I'm going to take the direct selection tool, the shortcut is A, and then I'm just going to click on the white background and then press delete on my keyboard. So if we select our texture, you can see now that we have a transparent background. And if you look really close, you can see that it's formed of many small colors. It doesn't look great if you zoom in very close, but at 100%, it looks just like the original watercolor texture. Now I'm going to create a black background using the rectangle tool. Just going to send it to the back and let's zoom in. Sometimes you might get white areas around your watercolor, and it looks like my texture actually turned out pretty good. And if you see those areas, you can take the direct selection tool, select the area you want to delete, and then just press delete on your keyboard. I'm going to undo that. And as I told you before, we have these small empty areas that we will need to fix. It's really easy to do that, and you can use many tools like the pencil tool or the brush tool, or even the anchor points tool to fill those areas, and I'm going to show you how. So for this area over here, I'm going to press A on my keyboard for the direct selection tool and then just select this area. Then I am going to go to the pen tool, and under it I have delete anchor point tool, and I am just going to delete this anchor point. And just like that, this area is fixed. So let's press A again and select this one. Then press minus on your keyboard to delete this point. Now some areas might not work with that, so let's select this one, and I am going to select the blob brush tool and just come here, and just like that the error is fixed. So let's do this too. So the blob brush tool, and there you have it. Now there are many tiny areas and it takes a lot of time to fix each one, so I'm going to make a few more and then just leave it like that. So I filled in most of the large empty areas, and it's up to you if you want to fix all the small empty areas or just the large ones. Sometimes some of them are so small that you will only be able to see them if you zoom in really close, and it takes a really long time to clean everything, but if you want to, you can do that. So now I am going to delete the background, and this is our finished watercolor texture. If you want, you can save it as an Adobe Illustrator file or as an EPS file. Hope you've enjoyed this tutorial. If you want to see more Photoshop and Illustrator tutorials, please visit my blog or subscribe to my channel. Thanks for watching!